So this track is called Feel So Good. And I write a lot of my songs just on like an acoustic or electric on tour. You know, I get home after the gig, I get an idea on a day off. And I was actually inspired by Al Green, because I know he wrote a lot of his songs on guitar. And I think singers kind of write things in a weird way. Like, we don't think about like key or form, obviously, you know? We just like, oh, it sounds good, which often leads us to places where if you're coming from just like a more theoretical standpoint, you wouldn't go.
Right.
It neither works or it doesn't work, right. You know? And you notice that I changed key in this one, because one demo was in one key and then I cut another demo in another key and I was like, wait a minute, I can make this work.
Right.
And it's actually this cool Quincy Jones jazz thing. I'm again like a real hip hop baby. And I think any real student of hip hop has to also love disco. You know, so I grew up on MJ, Off the Wall. That was a huge album for me right. as a kid. So I wanted to kind of have that fun party energy. And Marcus Machado, I got to shout him out on guitar, really is a student of that type of guitar. You know, it's really a difficult thing to do, that Nile Rodgers, just that Prince kind of pocket Isley Brothers feel. And I got to shout out Justin Brown, because most drummers would play that hi-hat with two hands, and he played it with one hand, which I defy any drummer to do. It's totally insane. Yeah.
Yeah, at that tempo, that's really tough.
It's really tough.
Yeah.
So yeah, I called also Cecily, a great singer from DC who sounds like she's a disco queen. You know what I mean? Like, she's just, I heard her and was like, wow, you're the most pure voice I've ever heard. And specifically thought of her before we went into the lab. But that was the genesis of it.
Mm.
Yeah.
So just to hop off the guitar, I definitely remember recording that and a couple overdubs and just getting all the right pieces in the right places to really bring it together and making sure it was as tight the sound as his playing was. So we spent some time dialing that in, yeah.
Let's hear a little bit of the guitar in isolation, maybe.
Cool.
Perfect, right hand, perfect.
You almost don't even need anything else. You know, it's all the information is right there. You
exactly.
Know?
Yeah, you put that together with the vocals and it's already a song.
DJ, play my song till the early morning. Nothing you won't do for love. What did I ever do to have?
And then there's a second guitar part as well that are the donuts that give like a larger harmonic. Hear from the bleed that this was performed live.
Yeah. Has to be.
Yeah.
It has to be.
I mean, it's so perfect. It's like of and in the idiom in the most authentic way. Talia
on the bells.
Nice.
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of people know me as like a serious jazz dude, but you know, I'm from Minneapolis. I grew up Off the Wall and Purple Rain were like my first two big albums.
Right.
And they're serious, but they're so fun. They're so fun, you know? And I like the idea of like a virtuosic writer and musician and performer also just being fun.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
That gets a little lost in the current
kind of
feel. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Also just like doing a party song that's can be serious.
Right.
Musically.
Right.
You know what I mean? But yeah, we had to do it here because as you can feel, I think it's really important for it to be live. You know, there's no way to get that vibe and that groove, like you were saying. You know, separately cutting stuff in or like doing it in LA and doing it in Berlin and trying to make it all work. It has to be, it's a feeling. Mm-hmm. And it's very, it's like a bespoke suit. It's like tailored for the song.
That's right.
You know, And I'm lucky enough, you know, to work with some of the best musicians in the world and the best engineers in the world. Let's do another one.
All my life I waited for your love.